brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods. Arden, rule the water. Strike King Lure Company, gearing up champions for over 40 years.
This week on Extreme Angler.
Sometimes they say go to the shallow side, the non-windy side. This is what's on the windy side.
This week, I'm gonna share a little secret, and that is the good old hair jig will be right back.
Feel that sun?
There we go.
A little largemouth. It's a little guy. And sitting in a little clump. Look at the weed right here. Small little largemouth. But you learn from the activity level. There it is. First little fish. Well, another week of Extreme Angler. You know what? This week, it's early season, bass season. That's an oxymoron. Anyhow, we're gonna be fishing everything shallow. Shallow water, largemouth, smash, bash, crash, you name it. Different baits, jigs, rodents, game hogs, maybe even big flip tubes. Everything shallow. It's only been 3 or 4 days since bass opener, so those fish are gonna be close to where they spawned. Shallow water, unpressured, and hopefully they'll come out to play. So we're gonna put all the things we know to catch those shallow water bass. Hopefully some big bass on soft plastics, jigs. Let's do it. He wasn't big at all, but that don't matter. That's the first largemouth bass of the year for me in Canada. And I'm pretty sure by the end of today, it's not going to be the last. Hopefully they're going to be a lot bigger. Oh, I'm pretty sure they're going to be. You like working this stuff right here? Look at that. Trees, pad with arrowhead. Put it up. Do not take your eyes off it. Keep the trolling motor going. Angle it, turn out. Make your pitches. Dissect that. On the outside, the inside. And just hop it. Let that bait fall. When wind comes down like this, I'm working against it. So I'm gonna dissect these little spots. The tree, look at that. I see one log up here sticking up. Working around, looking around. There's a log right here. Watch me pound a big one on here. But that's what I mean about shoreline stuff. Go along. Keep your wits about you. Take your pitches right into the heavy stuff. Put it right into the cover, right in. Solid fish. See that? I told you. Scrap. It's a little bit bitter. Still not no giants, but I'm telling you, if you dissect the stuff, you're gonna catch them. Put the trolling motor low, you're gonna catch them. And with these soft striking baits, they do not let it go. Hey, little boy, where's your mama, huh? Where's your mama? One thing good about these baits, look at that. That bait slides up there. Take it down. The owner twist lock. Pull off that other stuff that's on there. Okay. So good for a few fish. Just take a little piece off. And I rig it back up again. It's still good. You know why I'll still use it? It's still got all the little tails, little legs. You shake that around, it entices a bite. It might be good for one more fish. Rig it up, 3/4 way down, and I put it back in again like that. See that? That's hidden. That's like 99.9% weedless. Sliding little tungsten weight, 20-pound fluorocarbon. That's a 3-odd hook. Look at that hook hides in there. But when they bite, boom, out it comes. Trouble is our name. Let's get a big one. I'm gonna show you something. Like sometimes when I pitch, you see me pitch out like this, I'll click in and the wind's coming this way. I lift up the line, put it down. The line sits down. It's gonna have to have that great big bowl. So sometimes you pitch out, just like this. See the big bowl in the line like that? Put your rod down, let the line sit down. The bait will not pendulum and go that way. The bait will go straight down because the wind's not grabbing your line, pushing your line with that big bowl. You know, not flying a kite, you're fishing. That just helps you sometimes. Keep that bait in that spot you want it to go. Pitch out, down, the bait will go straight down. When the bait's in the area that you want it to be, strike zone, lift up, shake a bit. That'll help you. Around the tree. He's off. Pause, buddy. Look at this one. Oh my God. Turn that off for a sec. There's a big fish, right there. Look at him. Another one beside him too. Look at that. Look at that one right there. Swing it, look out. Watch it. Look at that. Oh boy. There's a nice fat bass right there. Hey, look where he's got that game hog, eh? Right in there, boy. And that's where the hook should find its mark. Right through, look at that. There and through. Just take it down like that. There, you pop it out. That's a nice 5-pound fish, 5+ anyway. That's what's working the shorelines are all about. Missing a few fish, so what? And I hate losing big fish, but when you get them like that, it makes it all worthwhile. Go around, go back to the same spots. We're gonna put them in the live well for some pictures. That's what I mean. Going around, missing fish, catching fish. That's fishing. Okay, a couple choices for the stop plastics. A rodent, rigged on 25-pound fluorocarbon, 7-foot heavy action extreme rod, XS1000. Another option, I've got another 7-foot heavy action extreme, except this time, the game hog. Striking bait, tungsten sliding weight, again, 25-pound fluorocarbon with a 4-odd hook, XS1000. And another option, the Hack Attack jig, Denny Brower chunk, F700, ardent, like a little tank. 7.3, big jig rod. Alternate those different baits, different look. Let those fish see some different stuff. You'll probably get more bites and maybe even some bigger bites. Now, when I'm working this stuff like this, trees, overhanging, There's some logs, grass. I'll show you what I'm doing, okay? Look at that, man. Hey, pull around that log. He decided he wanted to come out to play. Spin around. Oh, there we go. That's a decent little fish. Just looked bigger when he came out to eat it. Spooky, eh? You're just a fat little guy. Let's put him back. Hey, look at him. Fat little bass sitting on the shorelines. That's what I like. Ready you? Look at him go right back down again. I'm just swimming that over it, letting it drop. Swimming it over, out he came. Wait an extra second, drop the rod, pick up the slack, wham, and hit him. That's one good thing about these baits. They're durable, but soft. And when you set hook, hook comes right through and it finds its mark every time. Some good looking stuff back there, man. Good looking wood, warm wood. Maybe that's what they spawned on. Hanging around. Eat on. Yep, they're eating in here. Look at, just a decent little fish, eh? Nothing wrong with him. He's not too bad. Look where he got it too, eh? Just don't, like that little game hog. Just a solid little bass. Let's let you go. We're just gonna keep going. 18 inches of water, maybe 2 feet, 3 feet the most today. That's all I'm doing today. All the shallow stuff. Have some fun. Catching big old hogs. There's a little pad right in front here. I always make a picture of this kind of stuff. I think you can see the bottom. They find the hot spot. They find the dark shadow or the little hole that you won't see until you get too close, right there. Oh, maybe too shallow. Never, man. The bass is back. He's covered with water. Largemouth especially. He could be in there. It is never too shallow. My boat can float. Guess what? I'm fishing for bass. Largemouth. I'll put that bait in there. Take my time. Just dissecting the shoreline, man. Looking for those big fish that are just looking for an easy meal. And this little baby, game hog, it is an easy meal for these bass. But there's no one around. No good one, look at this. Hey, sitting on that brush. Look at him. Hey. Oh, that's a good one, eh? Not a big giant. Just a solid fish, eh? Cannot get on this trolling motor. That's just a solid little fish. No big giant like we have caught, but you know what? It's a bass and he's sitting on the brush, shallow shoreline. See that? It takes time to figure stuff out sometimes. When you do, you catch more fish. But you gotta move around, there's different areas, and you get them. Wood, grass, pads, arrowheads, whole realm. And that's what we're gonna do and keep catching fish. And let the bait do all the work. You just lift it and drop it. They rarely spit these out. A coffee scent is incredible. They love to sit in that wood, don't they, man? Big time. Good fish. Look at That's a good one, eh? Look at him going. Look up. Swing towards you. Swing him up here. Oh, there's a good one again. See what I mean? Working those shorelines. Taking your time. Throwing the right baits in the right spots. And you got another good one. We're gonna put him in the live well, take some pictures, let him go. See how big bass can share an area? And you have 2, 3, 4 out of one little area. They don't mind sharing spots. I don't mind catching them out of there too. I'm gonna get a big guy out of here, man. I can feel it. This deep little corner here. Got good wood. Got good cover. Sometimes when the rock bass grab that, they pull it up. You don't want that to happen. If you're fishing open water, just swimming it, that's different. Put it up like this, push it up, tip, just down a bit. That's all it is. As soon as the fish grabs that, it's coming down. So you can work that wood a lot easier and pull it right over the wood and drop it down right into the wood on the sides, like right here. Here it comes, my boy. Here it comes. Just waiting for that. Boom. That's how they eat this thing. It falls so subtle. They just pick it up. They do not let it go. Right there. See? You know what I mean? Scrap. Come here, you. You're not big. You're small. Small compared to big guys. It's a little one right there. Little. Maybe two. We don't want the two, we want the maybe 6 or 7 that's sitting here. Time for a giant, giant. Wow. Recycle, man. See logs like that. And they're shallow. They're working real slow. It's gonna be monster time. I see some good logs here. I'm on point like a hound. Because I want to catch one of them big fat giants we caught earlier. Anything on a weed patch? Yep, big fish too. Oh my God. Oh. Look at the size of him. Whoa. Come here, you. Look at the size of this bass. Oh, cow. Where's he got it? Look out. He's going to be coming in the boat in a second. Oh, look at that. Hey, look at the size of this piggy. Holy cow, eh? Ho, that's what I mean. You do them shorelines, and you can find them giant hogs just like this on your lakes. Look at him. Let's get out of this windy spot. This is what's on the windy side. And you know what? The wind helps. You know why? They're not as weary. That thing comes down, that little hog bait shook. He's seen it. Look at him. Look at it. We're gonna put him in the live well, take some pictures. Look at you. That's a big bass, boy. Look at the belly on him. Boom, shorelines. First week of bass season. Shallow wood, weed, you name it, they're in it. Thanks, big girls and big boys. Ready? Go on, you. Look at him flaring his gills. And there's a big mama. Look at her. When it's early summer and it's warm, get in there. The largemouth are shallow, soft, salty, garlic, or like Strike King, coffee scented baits. The fish grab it, they don't let go. And if you lose a few, who cares? You keep at it, be persistent, you're gonna get them too. Hey, listen, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler. Get hooked, stay hooked, and we'll see you next time. You think I was snagged? I'm not snagged. I like it when they call me Big Papa. Oh, they ain't gonna break my heart.
Interstate batteries. Lucky strike. Spider thread, micro braid. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com.